Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. Hi, in this NUCIDA video, I'm going to introduce TestRail, a powerful test management tool used by testers and developers all over the world to organize and manage their testing efforts more efficiently. By choosing TestRail, you unlock a key ingredient that will help you prepare your recipe for success. In this tutorial series, you'll learn the basics of TestRail, from documenting your test cases, plans, and runs to capturing real-time results and generating meaningful reports. If your team is new to TestRail, we highly recommend forwarding this training video to all your team members. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell to never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. All right, let's get started. In this demo, you will learn how to integrate JMeter with TestRail to have all your performance testing together with your manual and other automated testing in one place. Before I start the integration using the TestRail CLI, let's go to the JMeter plugins configuration in the JMX file to ensure I have the plugin for JUnit Reporter. This plugin allows integration with TestRail by outputting a defined JUnit XML file. It also allows you to define KPIs or performance thresholds to use as pass or fail within the TestRail test case feature. You can do this inside a test execution run for any thresholds you want to define in your given system under test. Once downloaded, you can easily install and configure using the plugins manager under My Installed and Available Plugins within the JMeter JMX developer environment. You'll notice I've enabled my JUnit Reporter, and I've added it already to my thread group, which can be easily done by right-clicking the thread group, selecting a listener, and specifying a new JUnit Reporter. Once you do this, you can rename and define your performance thresholds as I've already done. Now let's check the JMeter JMX file configuration. In this example, the JMeter JMX file will define a single thread group, which will execute several threads or virtual users and any additional configuration that JMeter provides that you'd like to apply to this performance validation test. The next attribute is an HTTP request sampler for a given server interaction using our mock system under test. In this example, I'll use a dummy server that will provide results we can use to send to the JUnit JMeter reporter. So next, let's talk about the configuration for the JUnit JMeter demo reporter that's within this thread group. This specific reporter defines thresholds for two specific test cases. The first one is the mean or average response time, being no greater than 1,000 milliseconds. So, any requests found within our session that are over 1,000 milliseconds, or 1 second, will fail this specific threshold. The second threshold defines a sampler error rate, with no more than 1% sample error for any of the tests that have been run. Let's go now to the actual script that will be used to execute this defined thread group with HTTP request sampler using the JUnit JMeter Reporter plugin demo. Starting from the top and then executing the script. First, you will go and verify that the TestRail CLI is installed using the TRCLI command. The TestRail CLI is a command line tool that allows you to effortlessly upload test automation results using a JUnit-style XML file to TestRail. In this case, I'm running it locally, but you can also implement this easily in a CI/CD environment. In this specific instance, I copied and changed the location of the JMeter execution environment JMX file to be run relative to the executable. For Apache JMeter, this will vary based on the configuration. You'll have to configure this based on your CI/CD environment or local execution. Next, you'll go and execute JMeter in a non-GUI server mode using defined variables provided in the JMeter documentation using the JMeter JMX file that we just reviewed. Lastly, we're going to execute the TestRail CLI using our defined TestRail CLI configuration and credentials. In this case, I'm going to use an XML file that has the credentials for the TestRail instance, the JUnit JMeter XML that has been created from the JUnit Reporter plugin, and then I'm just providing the title to the actual execution test run that will be automatically created within our TestRail instance. Let's go now and execute this using the integrated terminal. The script is running now, executing and uploading the results. You'll notice it's now processed and has added two different test cases and results based on the definition of the performance thresholds defined in the JMeter JMX file. Now that we've finished the integration with our TestRail instance using the CLI, just click this link and you will go to the test run created containing our JMeter performance threshold tests. In my TestRail instance, you'll now see the new test run titled Automation Demo JMeter, as specified in the run script we just investigated. Within this test run, you'll see two passing tests, each having a definition of each of the performance thresholds defined. The mean or average response time under 1 second or 1,000 milliseconds is defined by this test title. And then the second one here, which is the error threshold under 1%. You'll notice both match the defined performance thresholds with both tests passing. The integration with the TestRail CLI and our JMeter performance tests provides an easy and centralized approach, adding greater visibility of these performance threshold validations, either locally or within your CI/CD and DevOps environments. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our ISTQB, ITK, X-Ray, and TestRail certified QA experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.